a quickie, because you know that's what I'm good for. Now, this story is a couple of years old, but I had heard about it off and on. But this weekend, or this Friday, Catherine Q. Becker was sentenced to life in prison. But opportunity for parole in 7 years. Because she cut her husband's dick off and threw that shit in the garbage disposal. Now look, first and foremost, this ain't the first time some crazy ass lady has cut off a man's manhood or ding dong or dick or Johnson and have done something to it. First of all, what did a nigga do? I'm sorry. I know that word has kind of gotten some people in trouble. What did a dude do to get his thing cut off? And why do we never hear about dudes doing stuff to women? You ain't never heard no dude pull some Drano or liquid fire down some girl's pussy. But no, seriously, I don't understand. And see, I heard about this story, but I never heard the full details until just now what happened, you know. I didn't think it was as bad as it was. You know, a lot of you all older might remember the Lorena Bobbitt or whatever, the crazy chick who got off scot-free pretty much. She cut her husband's penis off, drove with it, and threw it out in the field. Now, of course, doctors were able to save him, and he became the $6 billion penis porn man, and he was able to still go about his business. Hopefully nobody never married that chick. But this story is a little sadder because I didn't even know the full details. I just thought, you know, she cut it off, whatever. No, it's worse. The story goes like this. 50-year-old Catherine apparently poisoned her husband, put some sleepy stuff in his dinner, his soup. And he fell asleep. He woke up in the bed, tied up, arms, feet. Now, first and foremost, if you come to my crib, I got two mattresses stacked on top of each other, not even 3 feet high, dirty-ass mattress. No nothing. No nice little fancy white people bed, living room set. No headboard. I don't need that because I've broke plenty of them. Tied him up. Where did you find some ropes to tie him up at? Go into my toolbox. I have an empty-ass toolbox with duct tape, electrical tape, two flatheads, a wrench that I bought for my neighbor. Now, unless she was MacGyver, or I don't know. But anyway, the husband woke up, and he's probably thinking, what the hell? Or maybe he was thinking, oh, yeah, giggity, giggity. But no, this chick went, cut his stuff off. Then she took it to the garbage disposal. Now, this is a two-part thing right here. You just don't go put something in a garbage disposal unless you're going to do what? Oh, yeah. She did that. Think about that. Your dick just got cut off. She's walking with your dick. And you're like, what? Come back here. Stop playing. I mean, you're still in denial. Then you hear the... Oh, my God. What the plumber going to say the next day he come in here? Well, you know the reason why your disposal was messed up. Apparently, y'all threw a big old hot dog in here that looked like a dick. I mean, come on. And the doctors weren't able to do anything for him, but he was 60, so he's had his run. You know what I'm saying? You don't really need your dick after 60. Yeah, I know it's Viagra and all that, but think about that. I hate that shit because now I got to compete with 70-year-old niggas at the club talking about, yeah, baby, I got them Viagras and whatever. Anyway, when it's all said and done, this is a sad story. Apparently, this lady lost her mom in an early age, was raped. Her husband physically and mentally abused her. But still, you cut this man's dick off, dude. And look, I'm all about some gore. I go to bestgore.com, bestgore.com, you know, look at some heads getting cut off or some silliness. But the dick is just... It reminds me of that one song, Dear Penis, by Rodney Carrington. Fellas, you need to go today and just look at your penis and just... Because a lot of people don't got their penis, dude. And they may not even have a penis that they're proud of. I don't even know what else to say about this. This was just a quickie.